General characteristics of compounds of the alkali metals. See, here all the compounds of alkali metals are generally in ionic nature. See, the general characteristics is oxides and hydroxides, halides, salts of oxoacids like this. First, we'll see the oxides of oxides and hydroxide. On combustion of excess of air, lithium forms oxide like LiO2, lithium oxide, and some peroxide also possible, that is Li2O2, lithium peroxide. Sodium, usually sodium forms sodium peroxide and sometimes superoxides also, NaO2, this is superoxide. Potassium, rubidium, cesium forms the superoxide like MO2. This potassium, this M indicates potassium, rubidium, cesium like this. See, the, under the appropriate condition, the pure components of the metal oxide, metal superoxide, metal peroxide. So these are the metal oxide, peroxide, metal superoxide. So the increasing the stability of the peroxide or the superoxide, the size of the metal ion increases due to the stabilizing of the large anions by large cations through lattice energy effect. So these oxides are easily hydrolyzed in water. This reaction is like this. See, the metal oxide react with water. This is an undergoes hydrolysis process to produce metal plus and the hydroxide ion. When peroxides are reactive, that is undergoes an hydrolysis to form like this, 2M and M plus and 2OH minus, and the peroxide also possible. That's why I told you in the beginning, the metal sodium peroxide gives some superoxide also. So like this, then metal the superoxide gives superoxide reacts with the hydrolysis of water to form peroxide and the oxygen also. So the generally the bases are producers. There is metal hydroxides are producers. Then the oxide, usually the oxide and peroxides are colorless. This is oxide and the peroxides are colorless, but the superoxides are yellow or orange in color. The superoxide, the magnetic behavior is paramagnetic. Sodium peroxide is widely used as an oxidizing agent in the inorganic industry, that is inorganic chemistry. Then next is the halides. So the halides are the alkali metals, usually like from metal halides. The X indicates fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine. They have a high melting, colorless crystalline solid. Usually they can be prepared by the reaction of the appropriate oxide, hydroxide or the carbonate with aqueous hydrohalic acid, that is hydrogen halide. See, all of the halides have high negative enthalpies formation, that is the delta H0, FH0. This is high negative enthalpy formation. When the delta H0 F values for fluoride become less negative as we go down the group, while the reverse is true for the this delta enthalpy formation for fluorides, bromides and iodides. The given metals always become less negative from fluoride to iodide. Then the melting points, usually the following trend is like this. The fluoride is greater than chloride, is greater than bromide, is greater than iodide. Usually all these halides are soluble in water. The low solubility of the lithium fluoride, low solubility in water, because they have a high lattice enthalpy, whereas the low solubility of cesium iodide also, due to the smaller hydration enthalpy of its two ions. So the others of the lithium are soluble in ethanol, some organic solvent like acetone, ethyl acetate, pyridine, some lithium chloride also dissolved in pyridine. Okay. Then next is a salt of oxo acid. The oxo acid are those in which the acidic proton is an hydroxyl group with an oxo group attached to the same atom. Example, the carbonic acid H2CO3. See, the sulfuric acid H2SO4. Here we can see this we can write like this, COCOH twice for this, and this we can write like this, O2SOH twice. So the usually the alkali metal form salt with all oxo acid. Usually they are soluble in water and thermally stable. The carbonate like metal carbonate like M2CO3, the carbonate, and it's most cased of the hydrogen carbonate also, that is MHCO3. This is the hydrogen carbonate. They are also highly stable on heating. As the electropositive character increases down the group and the stability of the carbonate and the hydrogen carbonate increases, then lithium carbonate is not stable to heat. Okay, lithium being very small in size, then they have a polarizing power. The large carbonate ion leading the formation of more stable lithium oxide and the carbon dioxide. So the hydrogen carbonate does not exist in the solid form. Next is the anomalous properties of the lithium. Anomalous properties of lithium. Here, the lithium is exponentially small size, small size and high polarizing power. High polarizing power. See, usually the increasing the covalent character of the lithium compound, which is responsible for the solubility in organic solvent. Okay, now we'll see the points of difference between the lithium and the other alkali metal. Lithium and other alkali metal. First, the lithium is much harder. It is the melting point, the boiling points are higher than the other alkali metals. The next is, the lithium is the least reactive but the strongest reducing agent among all the alkali metals. Then the lithium is deliquescent and crystallized as a hydrate, whereas the alkali metal chloride do not form hydrides. Then lithium hydrogen carbon is not obtained in the solid form, while all other elements like alkali metals solid hydrogen carbonates are given. Then the lithium under the other alkali metals forms no ethanide on reaction with the ethyne. Lithium nitrate when heated gives lithium oxide, whereas the other alkali metals nitrate decompose to give the corresponding nitrate. The example reaction is lithium nitrate gives lithium oxide and nitrogen dioxide O2. Then 2 moles of the sodium nitrate to form sodium nitrite and oxygen. Then the lithium and lithium oxides are comparatively much less soluble in water than the corresponding compounds of the other alkali metals. Next, the points of the similarities between the lithium and magnesium. Similarity between lithium and
magnesium.
Here, the similarity between the lithium and magnesium is particularly striking and arises because of their similar sizes. The atomic radius of lithium is 152 picometer. Magnesium is 160 picometer. Then the ionic radii is lithium as Li plus 76 picometer. Then the magnesium is 72 picometer. So the main point similarities are both lithium and magnesium are harder and lighter than other elements in the respective groups. Then the lithium and magnesium react slowly with water. Their oxides and hydroxides are much less soluble and their hydroxide decompose on heating. Then both form nitride lithium nitride and magnesium nitride. The formula is lithium nitride and magnesium nitride. That is by direct combination with nitrogen. Then the oxides, lithium oxide and magnesium oxide, do not combine with excess of oxygen to give any superoxide. Then the carbonates of lithium and magnesium decompose easily on heating to form oxides and the carbon dioxide. The solid hydrogen carbonates are not formed by the lithium and magnesium. Then both lithium chloride and magnesium chloride are soluble in ethanol. Both lithium chloride and magnesium chloride are deliquescent and the crystalline form of the aqueous solution of hydrates. Yeah. Then next is some important compounds of sodium. Some important compounds of sodium is the sodium carbonate, that is washing soda, the preparation properties, and the sodium chloride, sodium hydroxide, the preparation properties, we can see it now. Here now the sodium carbonate, that washing soda. The sodium carbonate is generally prepared by the Solvay process. So in this process, the advantage is taken of the low solubility of sodium hydrogen carbonate, whereby it gets precipitated in the reaction of sodium chloride with ammonium hydrogen carbonate. So the latter is prepared by the passing of carbon dioxide gas to the concentrated solution of sodium chloride, saturated with ammonia, where ammonium carbonate followed by the ammonium hydrogen carbonate are formed. So see, the reaction is the ammonia, that is react with water and that carbon dioxide, passing through the carbon dioxide to form ammonium carbonate. Then that ammonium carbonate NH3 2 times CO3, then this react with water and passing through the carbon dioxide to form ammonium hydrogen carbonate. Then this ammonium hydrogen carbonate react with the NaCl, sodium chloride, to form ammonium chloride and the sodium hydrogen carbonate. Okay, the sodium hydrogen carbonate crystal separates, so they are heated, give to sodium carbonate. That is, the reaction is the sodium hydrogen carbonate on heating to gives sodium carbonate and carbon dioxide. So in this process, here ammonia is recovered when the solution containing ammonium chloride is treated with the calcium hydroxide. So the calcium chloride is obtained by the byproduct. So the reaction is 2 moles of the NH4Cl ammonium chloride react with the calcium hydroxide gives ammonia and the calcium chloride. So it may be mentioned here that the Solvay process cannot be extended to the manufactures of potassium carbonate, because the potassium hydrogen carbonate is too soluble to to be precipitated by addition of the ammonium hydrogen carbonate to the saturated solution of potassium chloride. Okay, then the properties of sodium carbonate is it is a white crystalline solid which exists in the dihydrate decahydrate, that is Na2CO3 10H2O, that is decahydrate. This is also called washing soda. It is readily soluble in water. On heating, the decahydrate loses its water of crystallization to form monohydrate. That is above 373 Kelvin, the monohydrate becomes completely anhydrous and changes to white powder, called soda ash. Okay, so Na2CO3.10H2O gives that is 375 Kelvin. Then it gives Na2CO3.H2O 9H2O. That strong heating, that is above 373 Kelvin or 375 Kelvin, Na2CO3.H2O on strong heating, that is more than 375 Kelvin, to give that white crystalline solid sodium carbonate and water. So the carbonate part of sodium carbonate get hydrolyzed by water to form the alkaline solution like CO3-, hydrolysis to give the hydrogen carbonate and the base. Okay. Uses is water softening, laundering and cleaning purpose. Then the manufacturers of glass, soap and caustic soda industry. Then used in papers, paint, textile industries. Used in qualitative and quantitative analysis for the laboratory purpose. Okay. Then sodium chloride.